ஆயிரம் நாட்கள் போதாது, இன்னும் ஆயிரங்கள் பார்க்கணுமே. அற்புத அதிசயங்கள் போதாது, இன்னும் அதிகமாய் பார்க்கணுமே. ஆயிரம் நாட்கள் போதாது, இன்னும் ஆயிரங்கள் பார்க்கணுமே. அற்புத அதிசயங்கள் போதாது, இன்னும் அதிகமாய் பார்க்கணுமே. இதுவரை காணாத நன்மைகள் செய்திடுமே, இதுவரை மாறாத சூழ்நிலை மாற்றிடுமே. இதுவரை காணாத நன்மைகள் செய்திடுமே, இதுவரை மாறாத சூழ்நிலை மாற்றிடுமே. நீர் வாருமே என் இயேசுவே, என் சபையிலே எழுந்தருளுமே. நீர் வாருமே என் இயேசுவே, என் தேசத்தில் எழுந்தருளுமே. நீர் வாருமே என் இயேசுவே, உம் ரத்தத்தால் என்னை மூடுமே. நீர் வாருமே என் இயேசுவே, உம் மகிமையா ஒரு விசை நிரப்புமே.
சபையில் நடந்த அற்புதங்கள் இன்றும் என் சபையில் செய்திடுமே. அப்போஸ்தலன் நாட்களில் நடந்த அதிசயங்கள் இன்றும் தேசத்தில் நடத்திடுமே.
ஜபத்தின் ஆவியை ஊற்றிடுமே, எழுப்புதல் அக்கினியா நிரப்பிடுமே. ஜபத்தின்
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the Gibson and Charles families, I extend a warm welcome to everyone gathered here to the dedication of their home, Gibson's Paradise. At this time, I also express grateful thanks to the clergy present here, Reverend Cecil Victor James, Presbyter in Charge, CSI Wesley Church, Reverend Jose Kumar, Presbyter CSI Wesley Tamil Church, and Reverend D. Raja, Pastor CSI Wesley Tamil Church. We also gratefully acknowledge the presence of our guests of honor, Right Reverend Dr. Moses Asirvadam, Bishop, St. Thomas Cathedral, Reverend Johnson, Presbyter, St. Thomas Cathedral, and longtime friend, well-wisher of the family, Reverend Jyotiraj from the Carmichael Center. A special and warm welcome to all the family of both Zubin and Vinodini who have traveled from far to be here on this special day. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God and are called according to His purpose. In spite of the inclement weather of the last week, we are all gathered here to join and celebrate this memorable and momentous occasion in the lives of our dear Zubin, Vinodini, Jessica, Hannah, and Mr. and Mrs. Charles. And for this, we are truly grateful to the Lord. To begin the program, I request our Presbyter in Charge, Reverend Cecil Victor James, to kindly come forward to bless the entry into the home with a symbolic ribbon cutting and to dedicate the home and its inhabitants to the service of the Lord.
Offer a word of prayer and then dedicate this house. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for your steadfast love towards each one of us. Thank you, God, for granting us this day in our lives to glorify your holy name through our words and deeds, to experience your faithfulness and in turn magnify your holy name. We thank you, God, for the way you have shown your mercy and grace upon Zubin and his beloved family. We thank you, God, for granting them this house as your gift and as a manifestation of your love towards them. As we dedicate this house in your triune name, Lord, we pray that you would take all glory and honor. May each of us, and particularly the family, experience your presence during this dedication service, and thereafter as they continue to live in this house. May all those who enter into this house experience your presence and your blessings. And may thy children who live here experience your presence and your peace that surpasseth all understanding. We commit ourselves and this dedication service into your mighty hands. Be with us, lead us, and guide us. Take all glory and honor. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Showers of blessing, this is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, fed from the Savior above. Showers of blessings, showers of blessings we need. Mercy drops round us a-falling, but for the showers we plead.
I bless and dedicate this house, Gibson's Paradise, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
There shall be showers of blessing, this is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we plead.
Proverbs chapter 24 verses 3-4. By wisdom a house is built, and my understanding it is established. By knowledge the rooms are filled with all precious and pleasant riches.
ஜெபிப்போம். கிருபை நிறைந்த எங்கள் நல்ல ஆண்டவரே, ஆசீர்வாதமான இந்த புதிய நாளுக்காக ஆண்டவருக்கு ஸ்தோத்திரங்களை ஏறெடுக்கிறோம். கடவுளுடைய நாதி தீர்மானத்தின்படி எங்கள் திருச்சபையின் அன்பான செயலர் அவருடைய இல்லம் இன்று அர்ப்பணம் செய்யப்பட ஆண்டவர் அருள் தந்தீர். அதற்காக நாங்கள் உமக்கு ஸ்தோத்திரங்களை ஏறெடுக்கின்றோம். வெகு காலமாக குடும்பமாய் தமது பிள்ளைகள் யோசித்த காரியத்தை, கடினமாக பிரயாசப்பட்ட அவருடைய முயற்சியை இந்நாளில் ஆண்டவர் நிறைவேற்றி தந்த தயவுக்காக உமக்கு நாங்கள் நன்றிகளையும் ஸ்தோத்திரங்களையும் ஏறெடுக்கின்றோம். ஆண்டவரே, இந்த லிவிங் ரூமிலே நின்று ஆண்டவரை நோக்கி பார்த்து குடும்பத்தாருடைய ஆசீர்வாதத்திற்காக ஜெபிக்கின்ற பொழுது ஆண்டவரே, இறை பிரசன்னத்தால் இந்த அறையை ஆண்டவர் ஆசீர்வதிக்க வேண்டும் என்று சொல்லி ஜெபிக்கின்றோம். தூர காட்சிகளை, உம்முடைய தரிசனங்களை ஆண்டவர் குடும்பத்தின் பிள்ளைகளுக்கு தந்து மகிழ்ச்சியோடு வாழ்வதற்கு தேவரீர் தயை புரிய வேண்டும் என்று நாங்கள் வேண்டிக் கொள்கிறோம். இந்த இல்லத்தினை கடந்து வருகிறவர்கள் இறை பிரசன்னத்தை உணர்ந்து ஆண்டவரை மகிமைப்படுத்த ஆண்டவர் உதவித்தாரும். உம்முடைய பிள்ளைகளாக என்றென்றும் வாழ்வதன் மூலமாக இகத்திற்குரிய பரத்திற்குரிய எல்லா ஆசீர்வாதங்களையும் தொடர்ந்து வாழ்விலே பெற்று வாழ கர்த்தர்கிருபை தாரும். உம்முடைய பணியாட்களாக உம்முடைய ஊழியக்காரர்களாக நின்று அன்பு குடும்பத்தாரை நாங்கள் வாழ்த்தி ஜெபிக்கின்ற பொழுது அன்பான குடும்பத்தின் தலைவர் அவருடைய மனைவி அன்பான பிள்ளைகள் குடும்பத்தார் அனைவரையும் கர்த்தர் ஆசீர்வதிக்க வேண்டும் என்று மீட்பர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் வழியாய் மிகவும் தாழ்மையோடு ஜெபிக்கின்றோம். ஜெபம் கேளும் எங்கள் ஜீவனுள்ள நல்ல பிதாவே, ஆமென்.
There shall be showers of blessing, send them upon us, O Lord. Grant us now a refreshing, come and now on a diver. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need.
Request Reverend Raja, Pastor at Wesley Church, and Mrs. Vinodhani Mispa to please come forward to pray for and dedicate the bedroom for Mr. and Mrs. Charles.
பைபிள் ரீடிங் எண்ணாகமம் 6 24-26 வசனங்கள். கர்த்தர் உன்னை ஆசீர்வதித்து உன்னை காக்க கடவர், கர்த்தர் தம்முடைய முகத்தை உன்மேல் பிரகாசிக்க பண்ணி உன்மேல் கிருபையாயிருக்க கடவர், கர்த்தர் தம்முடைய முகத்தை உன்மேல் பிரசன்னமாக்கி உனக்கு சமாதானம் கட்டளையிட கடவர் என்பதே.
ஜபம் செய்வோம். அன்பின் பரலோக தந்தையே, அருமையான இந்த நல்ல வேளைக்காக உமக்கு நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். கர்த்தாவே, இவ்வுலகத்திலே நாங்கள் வாழ்ந்திருக்கவும் அருமையான ஆண்டவரே வீடுகளை நாங்கள் கட்டி உயர்ந்திருக்கவும் எங்களை நீர் நினைத்திருக்கிறதுக்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். அருமையான இந்த குடும்பத்திற்காக ஜெபிக்கிறோம். குறிப்பாக அருமையான இந்த அறையை அருமையான பெற்றோர்களுக்காக அவர்கள் ஒதுக்கி சிறப்பித்திருப்பதை நீர் அறிந்திருக்கிறீர்கள். பெற்றவர்களின் மனநிலையையும் அவர்களின் வசதியையும் கருத்தில் கொண்டிருக்கிற அருமையான இந்த பிள்ளைகளை ஆசீர்வதிப்பீராக. இங்கே தங்குகிற பெரியோர்கள் பெற்றோர்கள் அவர்கள் நல்ல ஆண்டவரே ஓய்வெடுக்கவும் கர்த்தாவே அவர்களுடைய வாழ்க்கையிலே பிள்ளைகளோடும் பேர பிள்ளைகளோடும் மகிழ்ந்திருக்கவும் தக்கதாக ஆண்டவர் அனுக்கிரகம் செய்வீராக. அவருடைய சுக பலனுக்காக ஆரோக்கியத்திற்காக எல்லாவற்றுக்காக நாங்கள் வேண்டுதல் செய்கிறோம். கர்த்தாவே மிகுந்த மகிழ்ச்சி இந்த அறையிலே பெற்றோர்கள் மூலமாக உண்டாக ஆண்டவர் ஆசீர்வதிப்பீராக. இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் மூலம் வேண்டுகிறோம் நல்ல பிதாவே, ஆமென்.
And heart of this home. I request Mrs. Iona James and Reverend Johnson to please come forward to dedicate the kitchen that it may be a place of happiness through good food and fellowship.
Deuteronomy 28:8. The Lord will send a blessing on your barns and on everything you put your hand to. The Lord your God will bless you in the land he is giving you.
Let's pray. சகல ஆசீர்வாதத்திற்கும் நன்மைக்கும் ஊற்றுக்காரனராய் இருக்கிற எங்கள் பரலோகத்தின் ஆண்டவரே, அப்பா உம்முடைய ஆசீர்வாதத்திலிருந்து அருமையான பிள்ளைகள் ஆண்டவர் இந்த நல்ல இல்லத்தை கட்ட நீர் உதவி செய்தீரே, அதற்காக நாங்கள் உமக்கு நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். விசேஷமாக ஆண்டவரே இந்த அருமையான கிச்சனை உம்முடைய கரத்தில் நாங்கள் ஒப்பு கொடுக்கிறோம். கர்த்தர் தாமே ஆண்டவரே இந்த கிச்சனை நீர் ஆசீர்வதிக்கும்படியாய் நாங்கள் செபிக்கிறோம். கர்த்தாவே உம்மை ஸ்தோத்தரிக்கிறோம். ஆண்டவரே பிள்ளைகள் ஆண்டவரே இந்த கிச்சனிலிருந்து வேலை செய்யும் பொழுது எல்லா ஆபத்துகளுக்கும் நீர் விலக்கி நீர் பாதுகாத்துக் கொள்ளும் சுவாமி. நல்ல சுவையான ஆகாரங்களை செய்து ஆண்டவரே தங்களுடைய ஆத்துமாக்களை எவ்விதமாக ஆத்மாவாக பாதுகாத்துக் கொள்கிறார்களோ அதே போல தங்களுடைய சரீரத்தையும் பாதுகாப்பாக வைத்துக் கொள்ள நீர் உதவி செய்தள்ளபடியாய் நாங்கள் செபிக்கிறோம் ஆண்டவரே. அப்பா இந்த அப்பத்தையும் தண்ணீரையும் நீங்க ஆசீர்வதிங்க ஆண்டவரே. பிள்ளைகள் ஒன்றிலும் குறைவிடாதபடிக்கு சகல ஆசீர்வாதத்தினாலும் நன்மையினாலும் ஆண்டவரே நீர் நிரப்பும்படியாய் நாங்கள் செபிக்கிற கர்த்தாவே உம்மை ஸ்தோத்தரிக்கிறோம் ஆண்டவரே. எப்பொழுதும் ஆண்டவரே இந்த கிச்சனில் கர்த்தாவே ஒன்றும் குறைவிடாதபடிக்கு சுவாமி ஆண்டவரே மென்மேலும் ஆசீர்வாதத்தையும் நன்மையும் நீர் தரும்படியாய் நாங்கள் செபிக்கிறோம் ஆண்டவரே. இந்த அருமையான கிச்சனை ஆண்டவரே உம்முடைய நாமத்தின் மகிமைக்கு ஏதுவாகவும் பிள்ளைகளுடைய சந்தோஷத்திற்கு ஏதுவாகவும் நாங்கள் பிரதிஷ்டை செய்கிறோம். தொடர்ந்து உம்முடைய கிருபையும் பாதுகாப்பும் உம்முடைய பிள்ளைகளோடு கூட இருக்கட்டும். இயேசுவின் நாமத்தில் செபிக்கிறோம் நல்ல பிதாவே, ஆமென்.
Mr. Clayton Mohandas and Mrs. Lalita Clayton, brother of Mrs. Rosalind Charles, to dedicate the first floor living room so that everyone who enters will feel honored and blessed.
உபாகமம் 28:9-10 வசனங்கள். நீ உன் தேவனாகிய கர்த்தரின் கட்டளைகளை கைக்கொண்டு அவர் வழிகளில் நடக்கும்போது கர்த்தர் உனக்கு ஆணையிட்டபடியே உன்னை தமக்கு பரிசுத்த ஜனமாக நிலைப்படுத்துவார். அப்பொழுது கர்த்தருடைய நாமம் உமக்கு தரிக்கப்பட்டது என்று பூமியின் ஜனங்கள் எல்லாரும் கண்டு உமக்கு பயப்படுவோம்.
எங்களை நேசிக்கின்ற எங்கள் மகா பரிசுத்தம் உள்ளதையுமே இந்த நாளுக்காய் நன்றி செலுத்துகிற ஆண்டவரே. இந்த நாளிலும் ஆண்டவரே நாங்கள் குடும்பமாக ஆயர் பெருமக்களாக உறவினர்களாக நண்பர்களாக ஆண்டவரே இந்த ஜுபினையும் ஆண்டவரே வினாவையும் ஆசீர்வதிக்கும்படியாக நீர் செய்த கிருபைக்காய் நன்றி சுவாமி. இந்த இல்லத்தை நீர் ஆசீர்வதியும் விசேஷமாக இந்த அறையை நீர் ஆசீர்வத்து வாழ்கின்ற போது உங்களுடைய நாமத்தை மகிமைப்படுத்தத்தக்கதாக அவர்களுடைய வாழ்க்கை இருக்க நீர் கிருபை செய்யும் சுவாமி. எங்களையும் எங்கள் குடும்பங்களையும் உறவினர்களையும் அனைவரையும் நீர் ஆசீர்வதியும் இந்த விசேஷமாக இந்த இல்லத்தை மறுபடியும் ஆசீர்வதித்து அவர்களுக்கு இந்த இல்லம் மிகவும் ஆசீர்வாதமாக இருக்கவும் ஆண்டவரே நல்ல ஒரு வேலையை கொடுத்திருக்கிறீர். அதற்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். அவர்களை ஆசீர்வத்து அந்த வேலையின் மூலமாகவும் ஆண்டவரை ஆலய பணிகளையும் அவர்கள் செய்யவும் அவர்கள் பெற்றோர்களை கனம் பண்ணவும் அவர்களுக்கு கொடுத்த நீர் இந்த வாக்கியத்திற்காக நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். விசேஷமாக அவர்கள் கொடுத்திருக்கிற அந்த பிள்ளைகளையும் நீர் ஆசீர்வதியும் ஒவ்வொருவரையும் நீர் ஆசீர்வத்து இந்த நாளுக்குரிய ஆசீர்வத்தை தந்து இந்த எல்லா முழுவதும் உங்களது பிரசன்னம் இருந்து துவக்கம் முதல் முடிவு வரை உங்களது பிரசன்னம் இருந்து வழி நடத்தி ஆசீர்வத்தல் வேண்டுமா இயேசுவின் மூலம் வேண்டிக் கொள்கிறோம்
சுவாமி.
Sundarathai Lazarus and Mrs. Sugandhi Samuel, Zubin's aunts who have traveled from Chennai to be with us today. I request them to dedicate this bedroom for Zubin and Vino, that it may be a restful place for them at the end of every day in their busy lives.
One another, and if any has complaint against another, forgive each other as the Lord has forgiven us. So you also must forgive. But above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body and be thankful. We thank you, Lord, that you have brought us all to celebrate this wonderful occasion in the life of Zubin and Vinodini, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you have heard the desires of the heart and you have fulfilled their desires, Lord. Lord, we dedicate this place and this bedroom into your loving hands, Lord. Lord, this is a place where they will be planning so many things and coming into your presence, Lord, asking for your wisdom and guidance. We commit this place into your hands, Lord. And at every turn in their lives, every point in their lives, as they come together, as they plan, and as they ask for your advice, Lord, we pray that your presence will be very real to them, very near to them, Lord. And Lord, as you have answered their prayers in the past, as you have given them the desires of their hearts in the past, Lord, we believe that you will complete their desires, Lord, that you will fulfill all their desires. And when they come to your presence, Lord, we pray, Lord, that your presence will be very real to them, Lord, and that you will advise them, that they will hear your still small voice, Lord, and will be able to dedicate and do everything according to what you want them to do. We pray, Lord, that this place will be a place where they come to rest, where they will come into your presence, and Lord, where love will abide. We commit this place into your hands, Lord, and we pray that you will continue to bless them. And even as they plan for various things in their lives, as they come to various points in their lives, Lord, as they have to take decisions, that your presence will be there and your wisdom will prevail. Asking all this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Legacy, this room is their dream, the music room. I request Miss Anita Anandraj, beloved cousin, of Zubin from Chennai, and Reverend George Cornelius, uncle by marriage, and one of the most important voices of the Tabernacle Choir, to bless and dedicate this music room for the glory of God.
16 and 17. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thanksgiving in your hearts to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him.
Let's pray. Psalmist David says, I will sing unto the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God when I have my being. This virtue of praising you has been inherited from late George Ebenezer Gibson, Sudhirana. Now Zubin, Vinodini, Jessica, Hannah, all of them are reckoned singers. They made a name for themselves. Lord Jesus, as Zubin is planning to have a small music school here, the students who come here to learn music, apart from learning their music, they may also know that this is a Christian home where music is honored and glorified. Bless them, you undertake for them. In Jesus' name I ask. Amen.
To pray for and dedicate this kitchenette on the first floor.
From Psalm chapter 23 verses 5 and 6. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Let us pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, Master, we thank you and praise you for all the grace and mercy on Zubin and Vinodini, Jessica, Hannah, and Mr. and Mrs. Charles for giving them this lovely house, God. Master, we pray especially for this place, this small kitchenette which you have planned, Lord Jesus. It is a dream of the family, Lord Jesus, to have something like this. Master, I ask you to bless all the food that is prepared over here so that it can bring nutrition and health to everyone who eats of it. And also, Lord Jesus, I pray that your protection be over here, that, Lord Jesus, no harm may come to anyone out of this place. This place will be a place of joy and happiness. Lord Jesus, once again, I bless this kitchen in your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
எபிரேயர் 13 அதிகாரம் வசனம் 2. அந்நியரை உபசரிக்க மறவாதிருங்கள், அதனாலே சிலர் அறியாமல் தேவ தூதரையும் உபசரித்ததுண்டு.
தூயாதி தூயவரே, உமை நன்றியோடு துதிக்கின்றோம், ஸ்தோத்திரம் நோகத்தவே. தேவத்தாமே, இந்த காரியம் உமால் வந்தது என்று சொன்னால் தேவர்த்தாமே அது மிகையாக, அது உம்முடைய பிரசன்னத்தினாலே குடும்பங்களை கட்டி தேவர்த்தாமே குடும்பத்தின் தேவைகளை சந்தித்து வழி நடத்துகின்ற தேவனே உம்மை நன்றியோடு துதிக்கின்றோம், ஸ்தோத்திரிக்கின்றோம். குறிப்பாக இந்த விருந்தினர்கள் அறையை நீர் ஆசீர்வதிக்கும்படியாகும். இதிலே வந்து தங்க இருக்கின்ற விருந்தினர்கள் ஊழியர்கள் யாவரையும் கூட நீர் ஆசீர்வதித்து தேவர் தாமே உம்முடைய அன்பை ஒரு இந்த குடும்பத்தாரோடு பிரதிபலிக்கவும் நீர் உதவி செய்யும்படியாக ஜெபிக்கின்றோம். அநேகருக்கு இது ஒரு பெரிய ஆசீர்வாதமான ஸ்தலமாக அமைய நீர் உதவி செய்யும்படியாக ஜெபிக்கின்றோம். இதற்குள்ளாக பிரவேசிக்கின்றவர்கள் தேவத்தாமே உன்னுடைய மெய் சமாதானத்தை பெற்று தேவத்தாமே சாட்சியாக திகழ நீர் உதவி செய்யும்படியாக ஜெபிக்கின்றோம். உம்முடைய நாமத்தினாலே இந்த வீட்டை நாங்கள் இந்த அறையை நாங்கள் ஆசீர்வதிக்கின்றோம். நீரை பொறுப்படுத்தி வழி நடத்த வேண்டுமாறு இரட்சகர் மீட்பருமாக இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் ஈடு இணையற்ற நாமத்தில் வேண்டிக் கொள்கிறோம் பிதாவே. ஆமென்.
சாம்ஸ் 4:8. In peace I will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make me dwell in safety.
Our gracious Heavenly Father, we be thy children gathered at thy name, thank thee, praise thee, magnify and glorify thy holy name, Lord. Lord, thank you for this lift, Lord Master. Lord, in Gibson's paradise, Lord Master, we pray that this lift is for all the safety and comfort of every member that is going in this lift every day in and day out, O Lord Master. For people who are coming as visitors, as guests, Lord Master, even when they use, let there not be any risk or any issues that they face here, Lord Master. Lord, as this is well thought and done for old people and young children, Lord Master, every safety and security you provide, O Lord Master. I pray this all in the name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Taught Thanksgiving service, I invite Mr. Charles to read a passage from the Holy Bible to prepare us for the message.
Sangeethangalin pusthakam 127th sangeetham 1 mudal kadaisi varai ulla vasanangalai kelungal. கர்த்தர் வீட்டை கட்டார் அருகில் அதை கட்டுகிறவர்களின் பிரயாசம் விருதா. கர்த்தர் நகரத்தை காவார் அருகில் காவலாளர் விதித்திருக்கிறது விருதா. நீங்கள் அதிகாலையில் எழுந்து நேரப்பட வேலையில் தரித்து வருத்தத்தின் அப்பத்தை சாப்பிடுகிறதும் விருதா. அவரே தமக்கு பிரியமானவனுக்கு நிதரை அளிக்கிறார். இதோ பிள்ளைகள், கர்த்தரால் வரும் சுதந்திரம், கர்ப்பத்தின் கனி, அவரால் கிடைக்கும் பலன். வாழ வயதின் குமாரர் பலவான் கையிலுள்ள அம்புகளுக்கு ஒப்பாயிருக்கிறார்கள். அவர்கள் அவைகளால் தன் அம்பார துணியை நிரப்பின புருஷன் பாக்கியவான். அவர்கள் ஞானமடையாமல் ஒளிமுக வாசலில் சத்துருகளோட பேசுவார்கள். வேத பாடம் முடிந்தது. கர்த்தருக்கு சோத்திரம் உண்டாவது. ஆமென்.
We now prayerfully invite Reverend Cecil Victor James to deliver a homily for our spiritual edification on this occasion.
Let us bow heads in prayer. Gracious God, we thank you and praise you for your word that refreshes us and leads us to all truth. Bless us by your word as we meditate upon it. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. At the outset, I congratulate Zubin, Mrs. Vinodini, and their wonderful daughters, Jessica and Hannah, and also Mrs. and Mr. Charles, and all the loved ones who have gathered here to pray for them and wish them God's blessings. To celebrate along with them this wonderful gift of God that God has given to them. This is indeed the Lord's doing, and therefore we all rejoice in it. Obviously, it is one's dream to have a wonderful and a beautiful house. A house according to our heart's desire. I do not know how long the family has been praying and looked various options in various places, and finally they have zeroed in on this place and this house that God had shown them. And by the providence of God and the grace of God, they are able to own this house, and today we are able to dedicate this house in the name of our triune God. On behalf of the host of clergy, the men of God, and all the relatives and well-wishers gathered here, I congratulate Zubin, Vinodini and the family for being blessed by God with this beautiful house. Who said paradise is a place where only the souls rest for a brief time? Who said it is a place where only world's best biryani is served? It is a place where Zubin's family lives here and glorifies God. It's a place where music is taught. Music becomes an instrument of glorifying God. An instrument to invoke God's presence day in and day out. So we thank God for this Gibson's paradise that God has blessed them with. And we are sure that God's presence would abide here. And we are also confident that God would continue to shower all wonderful gifts that God has in store for them in God's own time. I would like to congratulate them and appreciate them for the way they have prepared the order of service for this house dedication with Bible readings and prayers, a very well planned dedication service. And I am thankful to them for honoring me with this privilege of sharing the word of God in this new house. I have known Mr. Kenneth Gibson as the music conductor, trainer of Tabernacles and even musician at Wesley Tamil Congregation. While I was serving at St. John's from 2001 to 6, there were times he visited me with the invitations for Tabernacles. And even after I left St. John's, I used to receive emails from him. So though we were not very much acquainted, but I used to respect him for the gifts he possessed, and he used to respect me as the pastor. And now, after his demise, Zubin taken up the mantle, and just the other day someone remarked that he is doing much better than people have expected. So for all this we praise and thank God. The seed of faith that your parents have sown in you, both Zubin and Vinodini, and for the values that they have taught you, the wonderful nurture, all these things contribute in your day-to-day lives, and they come to fruition in your life in this manner. This is a grand fruition of all that you have learned and inculcated in your lives by observing your parents and also the efforts that they have made to see you prosper, be happy and progress in this manner. Psalm 127 is often read at the house dedications only to remind us that this is not our achievement, but this is the providence of God. Because even if we toil and work hard, unless God's hand is upon us, it will not be fruitful. And that is why there are three negatives that are used here to point out to the greatest truth and the powerful positive thing, or the powerful positive force, that is God Himself. The Bible says, it is waste for the builder to work hard or labor. It is vain. All their efforts are vain. And the watchman staying awake is vain. And it is vain that you rise up early and go late to rest. These statements, in fact, surprise us, because in order to have money, in order to have prosperity, we need to work hard. And for security, we need people, watchmen, or today we depend on surveillance. We use a lot of security systems in order to protect ourselves. We need them, but the Bible says it is in vain. It is important that you rise up early and go late to rest. But the Bible says it is vain. Only to indicate that it is not by these things that we are blessed, but primarily by the grace of God. If God's grace is upon us, even the small becomes big. All our efforts would be blessed, and we would be able to experience the fruit of it. The English version says, He gives to His beloved sleep. The Telugu translation, and I'm not very sure about Tamil translation, but the Telugu translation says, He would give His beloved while they are asleep. The two are quite different and contrast. English translation says, He would give sleep. That's also a blessing. There are people who can't get sleep. There are people who depend on pills to get sleep, and they resort to other means to get sleep. So a good sleep is also a blessing of God. Maybe the psalmist indicates to that. But the other translations say, while you are still at sleep, God is capable of providing your needs. So this is another inference that it is not just by our efforts, but it is by God's grace that we are blessed. So today, you have this beautiful mansion, a paradise, not just for you, but for your parents, for guests, for students who are interested in music, and above all, a place for God. So a house is not just our dwelling place, but it is primarily a place where we invite God to dwell in our midst. You know, the incarnation is a beautiful indication to the fact that God would like to dwell in our midst. We always imagine that God is up in heaven. That's what we pray, our Father in heaven. Indeed, God is in heaven. But more so, He would like to be in our midst at all times. And we also read in the book of Revelation that, behold, I stand at the door and knock, and whoever listens and opens the door, I will come in and I will stay with them. And elsewhere in John's Gospel, we read that we would, Father and I would dwell with you. So God would like to dwell with us. So it is our prayer that you would invite God to dwell with you at all times. And when God dwells in our midst, do we lack anything? David wrote a beautiful psalm. You know, he wrote all the psalms very beautifully, and Psalm 23 is one of the beautiful psalms. It can be read in any occasion, on your birthday, at the housewarming, at someone's funeral, both in joy and sorrow, you can just read that psalm. And the psalmist says, when the Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. And there is another translation for it which says, when the Lord is my shepherd, that is enough. So when God dwells in your midst, that is enough. No harm would befall you. No sickness would torment you. You will have the perfect peace. Because only God is the giver of perfect peace. So when you have God with you, you would not only have the material things, but also the perfect peace that comes from God alone. When Jesus visited the house of Zacchaeus, we see that not only his life was transformed, but also it became a place of salvation. Zacchaeus, who was hated by the Jews for the way he collected taxes for the Roman government, collected more than required, and by that he procured amassed a lot of wealth. But there came a time in his life when he encountered Jesus, not only at that sycamore tree, but in his house, very personally, there was a complete transformation in his life. He said, you know, I confess my sins, and whatever I have taken wrongly, I would give it back. And Jesus said, salvation has come to this house today. So when you have God with you, you will not only have the material benefits, not only the protection, but above all, the salvation that comes from God. So may this house be a house where people would experience Christ's presence, and thereby the light of God that dispels every kind of darkness and grants salvation from above. So may the music ministry not only earn you your livelihood, but also become a source of inspiration for people to grasp the love of God and be drawn towards that light of Christ. So it is God who provides all that we need. It is God who protects, and it is God who gives us all our heart's desires. In Philippians chapter 4 verse 19 we read that from the riches of his glory that he provides all our needs. From his riches. Can anyone imagine God's riches? The whole universe belongs to him. Everything that is created and not yet created belongs to him. So when he gives, when God gives, he gives abundantly, immeasurably. We cannot really count God's blessings. So for the blessings that you are able to realize, and for the blessings that you have not yet realized, you must always remain grateful to God. And God has in store many more wonderful blessings in your life, and it is our prayer that in God's time he would unravel those blessings to you. He would unpack those blessings for you, and you must always be content with what God gives you, and also be grateful to God for God for for what God bestows upon you. You know, a house is a place, certainly, and as we know, it is a place where you are welcomed. It is a place where you are unjudged. You are accepted as you are. Outside world is ready to judge you, to point fingers at you. But this is a place where you are accepted as you are. You are unjudged. It is a place where you are supported by your family, by your children, and children are supported by family and all the loved ones. It is a place where your children would grow and are nurtured in the fear and in the favor of God. A house is not only a place, but also a feeling. You feel secured when you are at home. You feel loved when you are at home. Just the other day, I attended a memorial service where children were recounting the way their father had provided all their needs. You know, they were saying it just needed one phone call for their father to attend their needs. In the school, whenever the teacher gave any assignment or a project, they said, our hands went up first. It's not that we have the capability to do, but we know that our father would help us and actually he would do that project for us. You know, that is the confidence, you know, the children had. And I'm sure as children of God, all of us must have that faith in God, that when we ask, God would provide. Whether he would provide immediately, or he would provide it a little later, or he would delay it, it is up to God. But we must have the trust and confidence that when we ask God, he will certainly provide our needs. And this is a beautiful example that Zubin, Vinodini, and the children, and Mrs. and Mr. Charles have earnestly prayed and trusted in God's providence. And lo, today we are here to celebrate with them, to express our gratitude to God for God's faithfulness. Indeed, God is a prayer answering God, and this is a beautiful evidence for it. So may God's name be glorified. May you continue to experience God's presence, God's guidance, and the salvation, the peace that comes only from God, so that you would become a channel of blessings to many. May God add his blessings to the hearing of this message. Amen.
We thank you, Reverend Cecil, for this encouraging and meaningful homily. We now have a beautiful little ritual. Mrs. Rosalind Charles has two brothers who have traveled all the way from Vellore, and they will now hand over trays of gifts to Zubin and Vinodini and Mr. and Mrs. Charles as a symbol of their love, affection and blessings to them. Devasirvadam family has served the Lord for many generations. Music has always been the most important of all. We now have the cousins who will render a special song of praise, thanksgiving and blessings. I invite Arunaka to take over. Congratulate Zubin and Vinodini, Jessica Hani and Uncle Auntie for this wonderful, beautiful house that the Lord has gifted them. And this song which we are going to sing says, this is your house, your home. We welcome you, Lord, we welcome you.
As we gather in this place today, Holy Spirit, come and have your way. Have your way. As we lay aside our own desires, sweep across our hearts with holy fire. Have your way. This is your house, your home. We welcome you, Lord, we welcome you. This is your house, your home. We welcome you today.
As we
offer up our hearts and lives, let them be a living sacrifice. Have your way. Be glorified in everything we do. Be glorified in everything we say. Oh, have your way. This is your house, your home. We welcome you, Lord, we welcome you. This is your house, your home. We welcome you today.
This week, another very important and joyous celebration for the family is the 60th birthday of Mrs. Rosalind Charles. Shall we all join in the joy of commemorating this milestone birthday? I request Jessica and Hannah to come forward and assist their beloved Amma in cutting the cake to mark the occasion.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Remain here. I request Right Reverend Dr. Asirvadam, Bishop, St. Thomas Cathedral, to offer a special prayer of blessing for the family.
Father in heaven,
What a great joyful time that we are having in your presence, O God. We thank you, God, for Zubin, Vinothini, Jessica, Hannah. We thank you, Lord, for Rosalie, Akka, and Charles Anna, and Lord, for Nitin and Shantini, the entire family, O God. We thank you, O God, for all your grace and mercy upon them all through the years, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, for this beautiful occasion where we, all of us, could join together in dedicating this house, O God. What a beautiful house, well built, just for Zubin and his family, O God. What a wonderful way that this program is planned and designed, O God. The wonderful people and pastors who are invited here to dedicate and bless this house and this family, O Master Lord. Father, we pray and commit this wonderful family in your mighty hand. As they would stay here, Father, I pray that as we have prayed, Lord, you have come here to bless them, O Master Lord. You have come here to dwell here all through their life, O Master. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the wonderful message that we have heard, O God. It's not our achievement, Lord, but it is your grace and your mercy, O God. Thank you, Lord, the prayers that your children have offered for many years to have such a wonderful, beautiful house, O God. Father, I pray the way that it is planned, the way it is built, O God, to have the parents here, Lord, the guest here, the music to go on, and the people to come over here, the children to come and study here, so that, Lord, the music will be played in different churches and different homes, so that your name will be glorified and exalted, O God. Father, I thank you for Akka Roslin, and I pray that Lord continue to bless her. Thank you for all these 60 years of her life, wonderful life, the good parents she had, Lord, the good children that she has, good husband, Lord, the sons-in-law, Lord, the granddaughters, and all of them. Father, I pray that you would continue to bless her with good health, strength, and long life, O God. Be with Anna also, Lord, as she's retired, that he will be a great blessing to her children and their family, O God. Thank you for Zubin. Thank you, Lord, for Vinodini. Lord, the wonderful way that you brought them together and being a great blessing to so many people, O God, through this Wesley Tamil Church, and Lord, through Tabernacle and other means, O God. Father, I pray that the ministry that you have started with him would continue to go for many, many, many more people, O God. Every people who come across this music with him may be blessed by him, blessed by you, O Master Lord. And I pray that you would bless their married life, that they would continue to love each other, live for each other together. They will live for you, pray for, live for the society, live for the church and friends and relatives and everybody, O God. Thank you for Hannah and Lord Jessica, Lord, that the talent that you have already bestowed on them, Lord, with music and other things. And I pray, may the children will bring great glory and honor to you, and more laurel to their parents and Lord, their grandparents, O God. Bless them as we have blessed this house. May your presence be, Lord, in all the rooms of this house, O God. Father, I pray, may this house be a house of praise and prayer, a house of rejoicing, a house of salvation, a house of peace and joy and happiness, O God. Father, everyone who comes here will feel the presence of God here, O God, as it is named as Lord Zubin's paradise, Lord. I pray, may this house be a paradise, O God. May this house be a mini heaven on earth, O Master. Everyone who come here will feel the presence of you here, Lord. They may experience the love of God here, through the way that they relate to each other, through the way that they relate to you, through the way that they show their hospitality, through the way that, Lord, they show love towards people, O God. Lord, bless them, Lord. Bless them, O God. Thank you, Lord, for all the provision that you have given to have this house, O God. Lord, bless them. Thank you for all who have come here, O God. We pray that your blessing be upon them as friends, ladies, Lord, church people and pastor, that we would continue to pray for them, O Master. Thank you for all the pastors who have come here, O God. Thank you for inviting all of us to have a fellowship with them, Lord, to pray for them. Lord, bless them. We love you. Lord, we bless you, Lord. All the message that we have heard, all the songs that we have sang, all the verses, Bible verses that we have read here, O God, all the prayers that we have offered here may become reality in the family of Brother Zubin and Vinodini, O God. We give you all glory and honor to you, O God. Through this family, may this surrounding be blessed, O God. This place be blessed, O God. All the houses here may rejoice because of this family, O God. They will come and contact with them. May they come and know, Lord, you as the personal Savior, O God, through their life, through their word, through their action, O God, through this music, O God. Thank you, and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The earth. The words are printed on the last page of the program sheet. May I request everyone to please stand.
For the glory of the skies, for the on earth and joy in him. Lord of all, to you we raise this our hymn of grateful praise.
The next and the last item on the program sheet, the vote of thanks by Zubin and Vinod.
Before we, you need to bear with us because it's our home, and I know lunch is there, and I know some of you are worried because I have the mic in the hand. And I'm known for talking and talking and talking and not stopping. So please bear with me. It's my house warming, so. Yeah. Okay. Before I start and hand over the mic to Vinodini to quickly share a testimony of how we landed here, may I request one important gentleman to come forward and maybe take his seat here. Mr. Rajendra Arapalli, may I request you, sir, to please come forward. And Vinodi was talking about bargaining, and that comes a lot from my mom, because my mom doesn't, I mean, she thinks a lot to even spend for herself, even when she goes to office. Till the end, she used the RTC bus. She believed that she had to walk, and she used the RTC bus, and she would think twice to even spend for an auto. But when it came to me, they would not think twice at all. My dad and mom would do everything for me. And despite their differences, I think as parents, they did more than what any parent would do, right? I mean, they did everything for me. I didn't have to ask, but my parents did everything for me, and I really, really miss them today, especially. But yes, nevertheless, I'm happy, and I'm really blessed that I have Charles uncle and Rosalind auntie. They're as good as my parents, and they've always done their best to make me feel that, you know, that they're there for me, and like my parents. So I'll quickly wrap this up. I don't intend to, but I really want to thank God, because he's seen all of us through. Our family has gone through ups and downs, and he's seen us through. I would also like to, especially thank all the presbyters. Thank you, Aya, and thank you, presbyters, and Bishop Aya and Johnson. Thank you, everyone, for making it and coming here today. Sparing your valuable time and being with us today. So thank you, everyone. I also want to thank my family. Of course, my wife and I together, we want to thank our own family, my co-brother and my sister-in-law, Nitin, Shantini. I think they have been the closest and always there to help us. And I can't forget Dilip and Christina, and they're hiding inside as usual. They keep hiding inside, and they don't want to be in the limelight. But both of them are as good as family for us. They've always been there through our tough times, through our happy times. They've always been there. I really want to thank both of them. They played a very, very important role in our lives as a family. I cannot forget my Atta, my dad's elder sister, who's been a very, very strong pillar through the tough times that I've gone through. I think she's always been calling me, praying for me, always encouraging, and being there. And and I'm really blessed that I have three akkas with me. Arunaka, Anitaka, Namlaka, they are more like a shield for me, right? Anywhere if I have to go, if there is some dust also that comes, they will ensure the dust doesn't touch me. You know, that's the kind of protection they give me. Wherever I go, whenever I go, at every stage, three of them keep, protecting me. Protecting is the right word, and they keep advising me. And I'm really happy and blessed to have all three akkas always being there for me. And I can't forget my relatives in Hyderabad, right? And all of them at different stages have always been there with me. I miss my grandpa. I've grown up with him. So, and my childhood, I particularly miss my grandpa George Gibson, for those of you who know him. And I also miss both my grandmas, though I could not see my I mean, I was just 8 months when my grandma passed away, my grandpa's wife. But I was lucky to have both Dora Mama and Bani Mama, both of them, their sisters. They showered so much of love on me. And whenever I go to Tarnaka or whenever I go to Safilgoda, I always I feel like the prince, you know, has arrived. And being the eldest of the cousins, and I always get that extra edge over all the other cousins. And so I really enjoyed my childhood with the blessings of you know, these people whom I really, really, you know, miss today, because it's a big moment in our lives today. And I really miss all these people, but I'm sure they're all watching from above and you know, blessing us. I want to especially thank all our church members who have come. It's more like family. Church members, when we go, when we have our fellowship on Sundays, it's more like a family than anything else. So I really want to thank all our church members, you know, who have come here today. My special thanks to all our relatives who come from outstation. I sent this note about 2 weeks, 2 months back, just to them, and I sent the date, and I was really thrilled of the response that I, you know, got from all of them who've traveled and come. Immediately, you know, tickets were booked in some time, and you know, confirmations came, and it's really encouraging for both of us, because you know, the kind of love that they're showing to us, and they've always shown to us, has been really, really special, particularly for me, because I've watched my dad always believing in relationships and believing in keeping in touch with people and meeting people and maintaining the relationship. And he taught me that that's very important, to maintain relationships, very important to maintain, you know, be with family, understand family. Everyone goes through their own XYZ, you will go through your XYZ, but keep in touch, always keep in touch. That's something he always taught me. So my special thanks to all who have come from Vellore, all who have come from Chennai, all who have come, and Mama who's come from Pune, thank you so much, and Polly who's come from Mumbai, thank you so much, because it simply shows the kind of love you have. And this is not the first time. I mean, just about a few months back, Jessica played in the church. She debuted as you know, and as an organist for the church. And even then, the kind of response and love I got from our extended family was really, really good. I really want to you know, give my special thanks to all the family members who have come from outstation. I know that I mean, we were looking out for a good builder to build this you know, place, because the renovation we did on the second floor, and we added a lift to the house. And we were, while we were looking out, we found this gentleman, Mr. Anand. He's standing in the crowd there, I'm sure. But Anand and his entire crew, I want to especially thank, you know, on behalf of my family, for spending time, for, you know, giving their best. There's a lot of work to be done. We were, in fact, contemplating, should we postpone the housewarming, because lots of work was pending. But still, we thought we'll go ahead and, you know, commit this day, commit this house to the Lord. And we went ahead with the day. So thanks to Anand and the entire team. His entire team. Have I missed out on anything? Yes. So, yes, as usual, I mean, we keep forgetting things, and I don't want to forget anybody this time. But I especially want to also thank my colleagues and Vinodini's colleagues who also made it here. They also, you know, you know, outside. In fact, two of my colleagues traveled from Delhi all the way, and they are in their notice period, right? So, but despite being in the notice period, I mean, they came all the way. It's really touching, because I mean, it's a special feeling, right? I mean, people just don't want to give up on you. They want to still come and be there with you. And I also especially want to thank Uncle's mother and sister, particularly his mother, mother and sister, but mainly his mother. Fatima, she's almost close to 90 years old, but she traveled and came from Vellore all the way. Thank you, Fatima, for coming. Thank you. who should host this program and who should be the MC for the program. And I mean, both of us, I don't know, for some reason we had one name in mind and we had Deepaka in mind for doing this for us. Deepaka, thank you so much for accepting to be the host for us and, you know, on this very, very important day for us. I'm sure all of us here miss James Anna, and I cannot but talk about James Anna and the way we all miss him. If he was here, he would have, I'm sure he would have been very, very thrilled, because he's the visionary, right? He's a man of who always thinks big, wants, you know, big things. So James Anna was here, he would have been very, very happy with the way we have done this house. So I really miss him. But despite what we have gone through, thank you, Akka, for being a strong support for us always, and you know, hosting this program for us today. Thank you once again. And I'm sure I have missed out on people, please forgive me if I missed out on your name, but I really want to thank each and every one who's come today, and this shows your love for us. So thank you, one and all.
Really, it's a great privilege for me, and I first of all I want to convey my heartfelt thanks to Ms. Samuel and Vinodini. God does always impossible things possible. It is a known fact. We have to recognize that one. Same thing happened in your life, I think so. That is one thing. And another thing we have to recognize always, everything is our good only. Whatever has happened, Romans 8:28. Samastam samakudu melike jarugunu. So that we should not forget always. Good or bad, it will give again good next. So that we should recognize always. So samastam samakudu melike jarugunu. So this has happened in your life. Because Vinodini rightly said in our testimony, because so many arguments, discussion within, she disclosed me. I never disclosed you. She told me one day, she met me in the park. Uncle, this is a situation. Don't worry, God will do work. Because many people came and seen, but I never reduced my price. I don't know, my children also, okay, daddy. That is one reason is there, because my elder son is shifted already to Lodha, Kukatpalli. So we all also want to shift there, because we want to enjoy with our kids, grandchildren. So my wife always loves even our kids, and even she's we are having pets also here, in the 3-4 pets since long 10 years. And we had 2 marriages here, our elder son, younger son, and 2 kids also here. So this is a blessed house. That way I told the Vinodini. So don't worry about money. Don't worry about this thing. You take your own time. That also I given them. So you take your own time, because I want to give to the only believer. So many people seen Hindus and Muslims, but I didn't reduce the price. And this is the really, that time also same way with the housewarming was in 2010 December 30th, I think so, 31st I did here, the housewarming. So many pastors, Sina pastor, K. Sina, I think everybody knows, he is the main person to do the housewarming here. So I am the seed of Sina pastor. So I am the seed of Sina pastor. So he is my spiritual father. So really it's a great, and my cousin also here, Mr. John Sundar Raj, he is, stays here next line only. I just encouraged him to buy here only. He was in Metuguda, he is a Wesley Church man. So really thank you very much, and God bless you mightily in the coming days, your children and children, your generations to be blessed in this house. That is all I want. Amen. Thank you.
Thank our photographer and videographer, Mr. Otherwise he will not give me the album, you see. Just yes. So yeah, no, like, no, thank you Willy for always being there. I think Willy is more of a family friend. I don't know if Rachel has come and mom. Okay, yeah, okay, but yes, and yes. Very important, right? Thank you, Vincent, and the entire catering community. Vincent, if you're listening, Vincent and the entire catering family, thank you so much for being the caterers for today. I hope all of you enjoy the meal today. We thank you and have a nice time.
Program with the closing prayer by Reverend Jyoti Raj and the benediction by Reverend Sis.
Our most loving Heavenly Father, We thank you and praise you for your presence with us right now. And we thank you and praise you, Master. You have done the whole program for us today, especially for the family of Charles and Zubin. And we thank you and praise you for listening to our singing of praises. We thank you and praise you for blessing us through the promises we have read, we have heard. And we thank you and praise you, Master, for listening to the prayer of all the people. And we know that you are going to bless our children who are going to live here shortly. We pray for them, we commit them under your grace and keeping. When they start their life here in this house, Father, we pray there will be oneness of mind, oneness of heart, oneness of soul and spirit. And they will be able to live a happy life, a blessed life, a prosperous life. We pray that you may be with them and bless them. We pray for their ministry. Father, we pray that you may continue to use them for your glory through the ministry of the church, through the ministry of Tabernacles, Good Samaritans, and other groups, so that they can continue to be a blessing unto many people. We also pray for their social life they are going to live here. They will be witnesses for you, they will be testimonies for you in this very place, and they will be shining as lights to other people. We at this hour very specially pray for the children, Jessica and Hannah. Father, we pray that you may be with them in a very special way. Like as you have blessed Zubin and Vinodini, we pray that you may bless the children, hold their hands and lead them to a great future. And in the future, like the parents and grandparents and all the family members, they will be able to serve you, they will be able to find a place in your vineyard. Before closing at this hour, we especially remember our dear brother and sister who are in our memory, Kenneth and Susan. And we thank you and praise you for the contribution they have made for the children and the family. And we remember with gratitude the contribution they have made to the church, to the music community, and your children. And we pray that you may help Zubin and family so that, Master, they may be able to incorporate all the good qualities they find in their parents. And they will continue to be witnesses for you. Once again, we thank you and praise you for all the family members, all the friends, all the relatives, all the clergies who are gathered here just to share the joy with this family and also to bless them in your name. Continue to be with them, continue to bless them, and continue to use them for your glory. For we pray this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. And the blessings of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you now and always. Amen.
Playing the guitar and for helping me in the pickup and drop, and Vivek Also, I'm running around for the catering. Thank you so much. I'm thanking Ebi in advance. He hasn't helped me yet, but I will take his help soon. And of course, Roshan, thank you so much for helping me. Thank you. All my cousins, thank you so much.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the saved on earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor for the master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, church in the wild wood, come to the church in the dell. No spot is so dear to my childhood as the little brown church in the vale. How sweet on a clear Sunday church in the wild wood, come to the church in the dell. No spot is so dear to my childhood as the little brown church in the vale. Church in the wild wood, come to the church in the dell. No spot is so dear to my childhood as the little brown church in the vale. Oh, come to the church in the wild wood.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in you. grace that taught my heart to did that grace appear? The hour I first believed, through